Hello and welcome to Honey Pop. This is a visual novel, I think.
Hey, how's it going? And welcome to another video. What you just saw were the first few seconds of the oldest video you will find on this channel, Honey Pop, for some reason, part one, tracking device. That audio sounds really not great, but anyways. I wanted to start the month by going back to the beginning, so to speak, with the first game and the first character that truly ended up having a lasting impact on this channel. In January of 2015, Flair and I had a bet. But the funny thing is, the actual details of the bet are lost to time. I don't remember what it was about. Flair doesn't remember what it was about. All we recall is that if I lost this bet, I would have to stream Honey Pop on Twitch. Honey Pop, for those of you who may not know, was an, at the time, newly released puzzle game slash dating sim, which was honestly more anticipated for being a funny haha than an actual video game. Either way, since I lost the bet, I had to stream it on Twitch, and was quickly bombarded with people saying that I was probably gonna get banned, as for some ungodly reason, people streaming the game were getting banned off of Twitch, despite the Steam version being totally censored. To this day, I believe the ban on Honey Pop is still there. So I started a playthrough instead, uploaded the parts to YouTube, and bada bing, that was basically the start of the channel. Flash forward to 4 years and 25,000 subs later, and here we are. Although Honey Pop had quite the cast of characters like Asian MILF Aiko, objective best girl Belly, and the opi alien Celeste, the character I think had the most spotlight on her was Audrey. Although Q is definitely a more prominent face for the series as a whole, it's not a stretch of the imagination to suggest that Audrey is the most recognizable of the characters. Audrey is, simply put, awful. Here's her in-game description. Audrey is loud, self-centered, and an all-around stuck-up bitch. She has extremely high energy and believes life is a party that's meant to be enjoyed. As a result, she all too often indulges in reckless behaviors like smoking, drinking, recreational drug use, ignoring her education, rejecting authority, and generally doing whatever she feels like. Audrey has no real sense of loyalty or commitment, and is only looking to have as much fun as possible. She's essentially the antithesis of girls that I usually gravitate towards. I tend to like the more sweet and kinda shy girls, and on the other end of the spectrum, I like Genki girls and some tomboys. Overall, the trait I avoid the most is bitchiness. I don't like girls that are rude, and although I can appreciate a certain touch of tsundere attitude, it's often a character archetype I'm not a fan of. Audrey is like a tsundere, but without the dera part, and she's not even tsun really, she's just kind of a cunt. She's also an alcoholic, a drug addict, doesn't appreciate anything you do for her, and overall, she just kind of sucks. My first reaction to her in Honey Pop was contempt. I hated her both as a person and as a character. What could possibly be the appeal in this? Surely she's here for this hate fuck kind of factor. But eventually my disdain turned into a sort of amusement. It was kind of funny seeing her be so foul-mouthed. Her ferocious hatred of being constrained by anything was almost charming. In time, I actively sought her out in the same way you watch a bad movie on purpose because it's funny. I no longer wanted to get mad at her dialogue or make fun of how bitchy she was. Rather, she ended up becoming kind of endearing to me in a strange way. She ultimately wasn't hurting anybody but herself. It wasn't like she was killing people or ruining other people's lives. Apparently, she does in fact steal shit, but I mean, you know what I mean. Plus, her dialogue is genuinely pretty funny in a so-bad-it's-good kind of way. The exchange between her and Kiana at the beginning is arguably the most well-known Honey Pop scene. Her voice actor, Brittany Lotta, does a great job capturing this bitch essence. Eventually, I made the realization that hating her is almost pointless. It's like expressing how much you hate Satan. Satan doesn't care, he probably considers it an honor. That's his mission in life. So why waste the energy? Audrey is so bad, she kind of loops around past this cunt event horizon and becomes weirdly likable in a way. It goes so beyond any sort of realistic bitchiness. She's like a caricature of a bitch. Then you start to see things about her that are actually pretty enjoyable. I actually really like her sense of fashion. It kind of reminds me of Ibuki from Danganronpa 2. I'm weirdly into that Hot Topic kind of look, and she has some pretty cool outfits. She would be an awful girlfriend, like you sure as hell wouldn't want her to be the mother of your children, but you know, as long as you keep the coke away, maybe we can hang out sometimes. Her burning hatred of conformity and work, while intensely destructive, is also weirdly commendable. It takes more energy to act this way. Plus, in Honeycam Studio, there is a somewhat tragic side to her character. As it turns out, the protagonist from Honey Pop was cheating on her with the entire rest of the cast, which made her develop a genuine hatred of men, and her drug problem intensified. So in some way, you gotta feel kinda bad how the one person she opened up her heart to ended up fucking her over that badly. Although, let's be real, the man-hatred and drugs really are her own fault. Luckily, Honeycam is not canon to Honey Pop, so Audrey may very well be safe. I also have a bizarre sort of respect for characters who I start off hating, then end up loving. Two examples that come to mind are Kyoko from Madoka, and believe it or not, Aegis from Persona 3. It really does take a lot to break my initial perceptions of a character. It's a lot easier for me to go from a sort of neutrality to a love than it is for me to go from a hatred to a love. So when that turnaround does happen, it's usually something I end up celebrating. Audrey is pretty much the same way. My ire eventually turned into a sort of meta love, and I think that's pretty cool in a way. What started out as a sense of dread whenever she was around has morphed into an honest-to-God yearning to see her again. I await her reveal in Honey Pop 2 the same way normal people anticipate a character reveal in Smash. Not out of some haha, it's so bad irony. Not for the laughs, although she is funny. Audrey is a character I truly do just want to spend more time with. Although Honeycam gave me a taste of that Audrey dialogue, it definitely wasn't the same. I want more of her crude mouth and bad life choices. I want to see what crazy outfit she comes up with next. I just want more Audrey. These days, Audrey is a character that, although I definitely have an unusual enjoyment of, it's still an enjoyment nonetheless. She strangely feels like a piece of my history. She's one of the characters in our Twitter banner, which is at Fither and Flare, by the way, so she definitely means a lot to me. Without Honey Pop, I wouldn't have started making videos. And without Audrey, I don't think Honey Pop would have been brought to my attention. So thanks, Audrey. Your coke problem did something of value. So anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy the rest of Fifth 25K month. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time.